God.
The word of God is power.
We are walking by the word of God.
The word of God is power.
Praise the Lord, church. Praise the Lord, church. If you know you're happy to be here this morning, and you know you're happy to be among the living, I need a better hallelujah. Praise the Lord, church. Let's bow our heads for prayers. In Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh Lord, we thank you for what you have done in our life. We thank for keeping us safe. Let your name be glorified in Jesus' name. We thank for making us to be among the living. Let your name be glorified in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, as we are about to hear your word, may we never be the hearer alone, but the hearer and the doer in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, I pray. Let's open our hymn to him 100. Are we there? Praise the Lord, church. In 100. Listen.
Thank you. the wife of the
Lamb.
Fill
my life with glory.
For all is
changed. All is changed. When Jesus comes to stay.
Let's have our mommies, our mommies. For Jesus' name, I pray. Let's open our Bible to Proverbs 22, verse 6. And let's read it together because that's our belief in this church. I'll be on our feet, please. Are we there? Please open your Bible for us. There's no time. Please open your Bible for us. There's no time. Proverbs 22 verse 6. Let's read it together. Train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. May the Lord add blessing to the reading of his word in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Shall we be seated? Amen. Amen. My topic for today is train up a child in the way of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. What do we mean by train up a child? Training up a child means bringing up a child or leading a child in the right way of the Lord. And when it's old, it will not depart from it. Amen. Let's open our Bible to Proverbs 13, verse 24. Are we there? Are we there? Proverbs 13, verse 24. I read because there's no more time. He that spareth his rod hateth his son. But he that loveth him chastiseth him bitterness. Amen. If you want to train up your child in the way of the Lord, you must use the rod of correction on him. What do you mean by this rod of correction? Rod of correction means cane, but not only cane, an advice. Amen. Let's open our Bible to Proverbs 22, verse 15. Proverbs 22, verse 15. And I read, foolishness is bound in the heart of a child, but the rod of correction shall drive it far from him. Amen. This is trying to tell us that if your child misbehaves or does the thing that is not right in your sight, you correct him. If he do it again, you warn him because he may be thinking that, my mom cannot beat me. If I follow this boy, she will only talk, she cannot beat me. You warn that child that if I get you with that boy again, if I see that boy in my room, I'm going to beat you. The child may be thinking that, only to talk, money tonight, talk, she will talk. If that child doesn't do it again, you can now use the rod of correction on him, and the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. If you beat that child, and whenever that child wants to do that thing, he will see the mark in his body and he will say, hey, my mommy beat me. This boy, please go away. I don't want my mom to beat me today. And he will never go back to his vomit in Jesus' name. He or she will never go back to his vomit in Jesus' name. Let's open our Bible to Proverbs 23, verse 13. Amen. Amen. Blessed in the name of the Lord. Proverbs 23, verse 13. And it says, 13 and 14. We don't know correction from the child. For if thou beatest him with the rod, he shall not die. Verse 14. Thou shalt beat him with the rod, and shall deliver his soul from hellfire. Amen. Amen. Some parents nowadays, they'll say, I cannot flog my child though. If I beat my child, he will die. And if I beat him, he will fall sick. No! Proverbs 23, verse 13 and 14 make us to know that if you beat that child, the child will not die. But it will save his soul from hellfire and destruction. Amen. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Any parent that want to eat the fruit of their labor in the life of their children must train them up to be responsible to themselves, to be responsible to their families, to be responsible to their nation, and above all, to be responsible to the church of God. Amen. For example, let's look at President Goodluck Jonathan, who was brought up in a responsible way, was once a governor of a state. Later, he became a vice president. And today, he's the president of the country. Amen. Mommies and daddies, don't you like that man? Don't you like that man? Who will not want his children to be like that? Our children will be like that in Jesus' name. Tell your neighbor, my child will be like that in Jesus' name. And the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Let's open our Bible to Proverbs 19, verse 25. Amen. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Proverbs 19, verse 25. And it says, Proverbs 19, verse 25. Smith is corner, and the simple will be well. And reprove one that hateth understanding, and will understand knowledge. Amen. If you train up your child in a worldly way, amen. I hope you are getting what I'm saying. If I get what I'm saying, shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you train up your child in a worldly way, at the end, that child will give you sorrow. He will give you high blood pressure. And he will make enemies to laugh at you. Sure, say to fear part of this. Tell your neighbor, deliver my portion in Jesus' name. And the Lord help us in Jesus' name. Let's open our Bible to Proverbs 23, verse 24. Amen. Proverbs 23, verse 24. And it says, the father of the righteous shall greatly rejoice. And he that begeth a wise child, that begetteth a wise child, shall have joy of him. Amen. Amen. Now let's open our Bible to Proverbs 29 verse 17. Proverbs 29 verse 17. Correct thy son, and he shall give thee rest. Yea, he shall give delight unto thy soul. Blessed be the name of the Lord. If you train up a child in the way of the Lord, that child will give you rest. If you are sleeping and you know that my child is going to bring money today, my child is going to bring food to my house. Because you train him up in the way of the Lord. Amen. And if you train him up in the way of the Lord, at the end, he will give you rest. He will give you peace. And he will give you joy. This shall be our portion in Jesus' name. Amen. Tell your neighbor, it shall be my portion in Jesus' name. Amen. But if you refuse to train them up in the way of the Lord, don't be surprised. Internet will train them for you. Pornography films will train them for you. Computer will train them for you. Even Satan himself will train them for you. Amen. Amen. And at the end, they'll not like to rest. Anywhere you go, they'll bring reports. You see your child in television. This boy, cool legs and arm about. You start shouting, hey, you start crying and dying. No, this will not be our portion in Jesus' name. This will not be our portion in Jesus' name. Duties of the parents to the children. Amen. Training the child in the way of righteousness will make him grow into a God-fearing adult. Amen. It will make him grow into a God-fearing man of God and a responsible adult. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Number one, teach your children Christian dress code. In some families today, mothers drag trousers with their daughters and make up kids. We should honor the things that belong to Jezebel and her children. Amen. Amen. And it's those type of family that spread Brother Assembly testimony today. The Lord will judge them in Jesus' name. I said the Lord will judge them in Jesus' name. Let's look at this. How can a sister from Brother Assembly be coming to church with mini skates? She start walking as if she's going to nightclub. She's walking like this. Amen. Amen. If she not enter church, she will not use handkerchief to cover the many parts of her nakedness. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Are they deceiving me? Are they deceiving you? But are deceiving themselves. It is those sisters that when service is going on, they'll be frustrating the effort of our coordinators. If they don't repent, the Lord will judge them in Jesus' name. The Lord will judge them in Jesus' name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. But we don't have to blame those sisters because charity begins at home. Didn't their parents saw them when they were wearing miniskirts and coming to church? When they're putting on attachment? When they're packing revolver on their head? Didn't they see them? But they'll not say anything because their children have overruled them. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The only thing they'll say is that we're in the jet age, we're in the computer age, we're in the jet age. I pray those jet age do not jet age just for you in Jesus' name. It do not jet age just for you in Jesus' name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Number two, monitor your children closely. Know the type of friends your children keep. Let's open our Bible to 2 Corinthians 6 verse 14. Amen. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. 2 Corinthians 6 verse 14. And I read. Be ye not equally yoked together with unbelievers. For what fellowship had the righteousness with unrighteousness? And what communion had light with darkness? Amen. In some families today, some parents, they have asked paid. It's not that the mother don't know how to cook. Or she don't have to take care of her children. No. Because all they have time is money. They don't have time. In the morning, they'll go to work looking for money. In the afternoon, they'll go to work looking for money. In the night, when that child has sleep, they'll be coming back home. There's no type of friend that's how he's keeping in school. Amen. The only thing they'll tell the housemaid is that Make sure my child eat good food. Make sure you go to school early. Thank you. Make sure you did assignments. Amen. Even that parents and their children do not know what that child is doing in school. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I'm just talking, I'm not opening the Bible. And it says, be not deceived. Evil communication corrupt good manner. Amen. Amen. If your children have good manners and they get to school and start keeping bad companies, don't be surprised, because that your child too will be corrupt. Amen. Because he's following bad gangs, he's keeping bad company. If your child is to go, is to do only. If he's a good boy, when he now gets to school, he now see bad boy that is to steal money. He now see bad boy that is to steal meat from his mother pot. That one to call him, John, I is to steal money from my mother pot. Oh. Come, can you follow me? The boy will not say anything. The only thing we will just follow the boy. Amen. Amen. And don't be surprised, because evil communication corrupt good manners. And an adage says, show me your friend and I'll tell you who you are. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So parents, I will advise you to make case while the sun shines. And the Lord help us in Jesus' name. The Lord help us in Jesus' name. Number three, it is the duty of the parents to monitor their children closely. Amen. Many children got corrupt. Many children and family get corrupt through the watching of internet, Hollywood, Nollywood, Bollywood, another type of nonsense wood. Amen. This is not a laughing matter. Mommies and daddies, praise the Lord, church. Praise the Lord, church. At the age of 9 years old, parents are buying phone for their children. It's not right. If you go to those children's phones, you start seeing bad pictures on their phone. Because they'll be going to all these pornographic. They'll be watching all the pornographic films. And that's where they got corrupt. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So, mommies and daddies, I will advise you to make case while the sun shines, and Lord help us in Jesus' name. Let me say something. Some parents, they'll be thinking that it's not happening in this Lagos, in this world. Like a film I watched. One boy, he went to look at his aunt he went to kiss his aunt. So his mother called him and asked him that, why did he do it? He answered, because he watched it on film. So parents, know this, that there's a spirit that follows those films. Amen? There's a bad spirit that follows those films. If you see those children, they'll watch Ben 10, they'll talk and react to it. They'll say, hey, shh. Amen? Amen? So mommies and daddies, make us while the sun shines, and the Lord help us in Jesus' name. The Lord help us in Jesus' name. And know the places your children go to. Some children, they just come, mommy, I'm going out. The mom just say, okay, they'll not say anything. If that is from, and it's from there, that child, those children, let get corrupt. They'll be going to their friend's house. It's from there they learn how to smoke. It's from there they learn how to drink. It's from there they learn how to abuse. Amen? Amen? Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So mommies and daddies, make us, for tomorrow may be too late. And Lord help us in Jesus' name. The Lord help us in Jesus' name. Number four, praying together. Let's open our Bible to Matthew 19, verse 13 to 14. Amen. Matthew 19, verse 13 to 14. There were they brought unto him little children, that he should put his hands on them and pray. And the disciples rebuked them. Verse 14. But Jesus said, suffer little children and forbid them not to come unto me. For of such is the kingdom of heaven. Amen. Mommies and daddies, there's a secret. But I don't know if it's everybody that knows it. Amen. Amen. Do you know that the family that prays together stays together? Do you know? So if you want to stay together with your children, If you want to believe in happily, you must make it an habit to pray together with them and the Lord help us in Jesus' name. Make them to know that when they wake up in the morning, that is not by their grace, it's not by their power. Let them pray. Let them thank God for keeping them safely. Let them pray in the morning when they wake up. Let them pray in the night before they sleep. And if you do so, the Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. And teach them the scriptures from their childhood. Let's open our Bible to 2 Timothy 3 verse 15. Amen. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. 2 Timothy 3 verse 15. And that from a child, thou art known the only scriptures, which are able to make thee wise unto salvation, through faith which is in Christ Jesus. Blessed be the name of the Lord. If your child knows the scriptures, if you teach your child the scriptures, anything you say, he must have Bible backup. Amen. Amen. If he said that shall not kill, he must have Bible backup. If he said that shall not commit adultery, he must say where it is in the Bible, so that people will believe him. Amen. And anywhere you go to, he will not depart from it. Even though it's in university or in polytechnic, we will know that my mommy taught me these things and it's good. So I will have to do them so that my children too follow my footsteps. And the Lord help us in Jesus' name. The Lord help us in Jesus' name. Let's open our Bible to Proverbs 18, verse 21. Amen. Amen. Proverbs 18, verse 21. Proverbs 18, verse 21, I read. Death and life are in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof. Amen. Some of us here, your parents caused you out of frustration. Though because you know to go on errand, because you disobey them. They will tell you to go and buy pepper. You say, no, I'm not, I will not go, I'm tired. And it is those calls that they caused you that is not affecting you. You see people that are suffering. You thought that is their uncle that is doing them or their auntie. No. It is because of the cause that their parents caused them. Amen. But let me prophesy into your life. Because you are under this atmosphere today. Any parental cause that follow you and come here is broken in Jesus' name. Amen. It's broken in Jesus' name. Amen. If you believe it, shout amen. Amen. It shall be so in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, pray. Let me say this thing. Some parents here, I repeat, some parents here don't like bringing their children to children's department. Amen. They may be thinking that it's children affair because there's no Pastor Moses there, there's no Pastor Thomas there, there's no Evangelist Sam there, there's no Evangelist Ike there. Amen. But let me tell you, if you want your children to be responsible and to be rooted in the Word of God, bring them to children's department and hand them over to our honorable pastor, Pastor John Paul Okoye. Amen. The Lord will use him to transform, to mold your child's life. I am one of his products. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Let's open our Bible to John 5, verse 19. Amen. Amen. John 5, verse 19. Then answered Jesus and said unto them, verily, verily, I say unto you, the Son can do nothing of himself, but what is yet his Father do, For what things soever he doeth, this also doeth the Son likewise. Amen. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Parents, let me say something. Parental example is one of the greatest force that molds a child's life. Amen. Don't do as I do, but do as I say. We only produce generation of hypocrites. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. What did I mean by this? Don't do as I do, but do as I say. As I have read in John 5 verse 19, that the Son can do nothing of yourselves. Amen. So mums and daddies, if you just come in front of a child and start kissing, just start abusing each other, fighting each other. Or that is, he wake up early in the morning and say, Junior, come happen to buy beer, and the boy will buy it. He'll be drinking it in his front. Come happen to buy stout. Come happen to buy all this, he go all these things. He will start drinking it in his front. Amen. Amen. You don't know that child is following your footstep. If that child now do what you are doing, you now call him. Don't fight as I fight. John, don't kiss as I kiss. Don't abuse as I abuse. Don't curse one another as I do. Amen. You are an hypocrite. Because John 5 verse 19 make us to know that what you don't want our children to do, you two don't do it. And the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Examples of children that are brought up in the word of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Children that are brought up in the word of the Lord are pride to their parents and they must do expect in life. Amen. Amen. Let's open our Bible to Luke 2, verse 40 to 46. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Luke 2 verse 40 to 46. And I read, and the child grew and was strong in spirit, filled with wisdom, and the grace of God was upon him. Verse 41. Now his parents went to Jerusalem every year at the feast of the Passover. Verse 42. And when he was 12 years old, they went up to Jerusalem after the custom of the feast. For verse 43. And when they had fulfilled the days as they returned, the child Jesus tarried behind in Jerusalem. And Joseph and his mother knew not of it. Verse 44. But they supposing him to have been in the company went a day's journey. And they sought him among their kinsfolk and acquaintance. Amen. Verse 45. I hope you are following what I'm reading. Verse 45. And when they found him not, they turned back again to Jerusalem, seeking him. Verse 46. And it came to pass that after 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting in the midst of the doctors, both hearing them and asking them questions. Amen. Amen. Number one, the Lord Jesus Christ, our role model. Blessed be the name of the Lord. If you are following what I'm saying, shout hallelujah. Mary and Joseph, who we all know are the earthly parents of Jesus Christ. Amen. They do go to the temple for every year sacrifice. And they went with Jesus Christ. Amen. They went with Jesus Christ. And when Jesus Christ grew up, he did not depart from it. Instead, he started teaching the doctors of law at his tender age. And we all know his tender age, 12 years old. Amen. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Some parents here, they will say, my son, I cannot bring him come to church. Stay at home because that place is too far. No. If you want to know the word of God, your children too must know the word of God. Amen. 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 Bring your children to church. Because some parents here, they will say that, Junior, stay at home. Oh. If they are going to church, say, Junior, I'm going to church. John, I'm going to church. Adam, I'm going to church. Oh. Those children will not be playing at home. They'll be playing football in the street like people that now have hand up, people that don't have anything to do. Then you see some people that don't know anything. Their parents will leave them at home. Parents, what are you not coming to church to do? Amen. What are you not coming to church to do? What are you coming to church to do is rubbish. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So, mommies and daddies, I will advise you to be bringing your children to church like the way Mary and Joseph did to Jesus Christ. They're taking him to the temple. And as you do so, the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. As you do so, the Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. The Lord will bless your family in Jesus' name. Number two, Samuel. Let's open our Bible to 1 Samuel 1 verse 27 to 28. Amen. Amen. 1 Samuel 1 verse 27 to 28. For this child I prayed, and the Lord had given me my petition, which I asked of him. Verse 28. Therefore also, I have lent him to the Lord, as long as he liveth. he shall be lent to the Lord, and he worship the Lord. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Praise the Lord, church. The parents of Samuel brought him up in the word of the Lord by dedicating him unto the Lord from his childhood under the care of Eli. And when Samuel grew up, he did not depart from it. Instead, he grew up to become a faithful man of God and a servant of God who served God in truth and spirit. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. He did not end up perverting judgment and died a shameful death, as the children of Eli did. But his life brought honor to his parents and glory to God Almighty. Amen. Amen. So, mommies and daddies, see Timothy. Timothy he was a small boy. How old are your children? 9 years old, that you say you cannot bring and come to church. I will advise you to bring your children and come to church. Look at Samuel. If you want your children to be like Samuel, if you want them to be like Prophet Samuel, bring them to church. And the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Number three, let's open our Bible. Number three, Timothy. Let's open our Bible to 2 Timothy 2, verse 2 to 3. And the things that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same commit thou to faithful men who shall be able to teach others also. Verse 3. Thou therefore endure hardship as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Timothy was brought up in the way of the Lord from his childhood by his mother Eunice and his grandmother Lois. Amen. And when Timothy grew up, he did not depart from it. Instead, he grew up to become a faithful man of God and a servant of God. And his life affected his generation in a positive way. Amen. Amen. Because Timothy was brought up in the word of the Lord by his mother Eunice and his grandmother Lois. When Apostle Paul saw him, Apostle Paul recognized him and blessed God for his life. Amen. Amen. So, moms and daddies, if you want people to look at your children, to be blessed in your child because you have trained them up in the word of the Lord, like Timothy's parents, obey the commandment of Proverbs 22, verse 6. And the Lord help us in Jesus' name. Amen. The Lord help us in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Number four, Jonathan Edwards. Jonathan Edwards graduated from Yale University at his early stage of 17 years old. Amen. Because he was brought up in the word of the Lord. Praise the Lord, somebody. Praise the Lord, somebody. Because John Edwards was brought up in the word of the Lord. He grew up to become one of the greatest American theologians. Amen. Amen. Number five, Katherine Booth. Katherine Booth was the founder of Salvation Army. And she was reported to have read the Bible two several times before the age of 12 years old. Amen. See Katherine Booth, she was 12 years old, studying the Bible from Genesis to Revelation every time. Who is not that your smaller children? Bring them up. Make sure they learn it. Even though to bring Cain. Bring Cain, tell them that you must read this Bible. And to do so, the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. The Lord will bless your homes in Jesus' name. Number six, John Wesley. Because John Wesley was brought up in the way of the Lord. Amen. Amen. He became the star messenger to the church in Philadelphia in the year 1750 to 1906. And because he was brought up in the way of the Lord, he grew up to be a prominent proclaimer of holiness. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So, mommies and daddies, I will advise you to bring up your children as the way all these people have mentioned, as the way that they've been brought up in the word of the Lord. And the Lord help us in Jesus' name. The Lord help us in Jesus' name. Examples of parents that did not bring up their children in the word of the Lord. Amen. 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 Number one, Samson. Let's open our Bible to Proverbs 29, verse 13. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Proverbs 29 verse 13. The poor and the deceitful man, the poor and the deceitful man meet together. The Lord lightens both their eyes. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Please, if anybody is sleeping inside, wake them up because this is very important. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Because Samson's parents saw that the hand of God was upon Samson. They left him out to himself. And he ended up losing the anointing of God on his life. In his life. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And Samson died a shameful death. This will never be a portion in Jesus' name. This will never be a portion in Jesus' name. So, if you don't want to be a portion, try to bring up your child in the word of the Lord. And the Lord help us in Jesus' name. Number two, Priscilla and his sons. It wasn't recorded in the Bible where Eli asked God to change the lifestyle of his children. Amen. Amen. Instead, he left them all to themselves. And they end up losing the anointing of God and the power of God in them. And at the end, their end was disastrous, disgraceful, and they brought shame to Eli ministry and Eli family. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Mommies and daddies, I will advise you not to follow the footsteps of Samson's parents. Not to follow the footsteps of Eli. But follow the footsteps of Jochebed, Moses' mother. Follow the footsteps of Eunice, Samson's mother. That's Samuel's mother. Follow the footsteps of Lois, Samuel's grandmother. And as you do so, the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. The Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. The Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. This is my advice to my fellow children. Amen. Because I've seen that in some families, parents are trying their best. But some children have decided to go the way that please them. They have decided to destroy their destiny with their own hands. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Please, there's no more time. That's why I will not read it. But just write the scriptures down. And if you read them, study it. And as you do so, the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. But I just want to read only one. Let's open our Bible to Proverbs 29 verse 1. Amen. Proverbs 29 verse 1. He that being often refused, hardeneth his neck, shall suddenly be destroyed, and that without remedy. Amen. Amen. This is trying to tell us that children, if your parents are telling you, if your parents are warning you every day, beating you every day, change your bad behavior, and you have refused, you are this strong girl. No, I cannot get from this thing. It's good. I cannot get from stealing. No, mommy, leave me alone. Don't be surprised, because if you too, you grow up and you give birth to children, the children too follow your footsteps. Amen. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And the second one is Proverbs 4 verse 1. Number 3, Proverbs 15 verse 32. Number 4, Proverbs 16 verse 25. Number 5, Proverbs 6 verse 20. And as you read it, the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. The Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. And this is my advice too to my parents. Amen. Mommies and daddies, please jot these things down. This advice that I'm giving to you. Number one, correct your children. If they do wrong or they do bad, correct them. Proverbs 13 verse 24. Number two, teach them the good things of life. Amen. Amen. Deuteronomy 6 verse 7. Number three, provide for them. 1 Timothy 5 verse 8. Number 4. Correct and rule them. This is the only one I'm going to say. It's in 1 Timothy 3 verse 4 to 12. Amen. Correct and rule them. See, some parents, mommies and daddies, do you know that it is possible for a child to correct and rule his parents? Do you know? The child can rule his parents by saying, mommy, buy biscuits for me, you buy it. Mommy, buy sweets for me, you buy it. Mommy, buy ice cream for me, you buy it. Mommy, buy bread for me, you buy it. One day, that child will ask you, mommy, buy woman hair for me and you buy it. Amen. And when the money is not there, that child will go and steal. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So if you know what your children to steal, it's not everything that they're asking and you give them. And as you do so, the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Number 5, instruct them in God's word. Deuteronomy 11 verse 19. Number 6, don't provoke them. Ephesians 6 verse 4 and Colossians 3 verse 21. Mommies and daddies, as you practice this, the Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. The Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. Let's open our Bible to Matthew 7 verse 17. Amen. Matthew 7 verse 17. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And it says, even so, every good tree bringeth forth good fruit, but a corrupt tree bringeth forth evil fruit. Amen. Parents, please, I'm about to round up. Mommies and daddies, do you know that parental attitude are contagious? Amen. Do you know? If you parents are hostile and abusive, your children will learn to fight. If you parents are faithless and fickle, your children will learn to complain and condemn. But if you parents are gentle and respectful, your children will be cautious and considerate. And if on the other hand, you are liberal and giving and generous, your children will be warm-hearted and generous because it was practiced at home. And not this, every tree bringeth forth its kind. I will bow down my head. Father, in Jesus' name. Father, in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, as I have heard your word, may we never be the hearer alone, but the hearer and the doer in Jesus' name. Lord, give us the grace to practice it at home in Jesus' name. Give us the grace to practice it at home in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, give us the grace to train up our children in the way of the Lord. And as we do so, the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, I pray. Please, let me say something.
Church, clap your hands now for the Lord. Church, clap your hands now for the Lord. You are Pastor who? Pastor who?
Uzube Okafor.
Uzube. Uzube Okafor, Pastor Uzube Okafor. Once again, for this wonderful gift, give the Lord a clap offering.